Welcome to the Spy Collection. I'm Anastasios and today we'll look at an old device from the United States designed for secure communications. This, the Privacom P25C. As you can see here, this was manufactured by SwiftStrike from Ohio of the United States. To the best of our knowledge, this is the very first time this device is displayed on the internet. Not because it was some sort of secret gadget, but likely because very few were manufactured and even fewer exist today. This is coming from the early 90s and we even found this patent application filed in 1992. This year also matches another reference to it from the Hacker Magazine 2600, Volume 9, Issue 3, which was also published in 1992. There we find this. Dear 2600, I attended the Winter 92 Consumer Electronics Show in Las Vegas from January 9th to 12th and saw a few interesting new products. Among others, the reader said about this event. One product I saw was designed to solve the problem concerning lack of privacy on cellular phone calls for any phone call where security was a concern. The Privacom P25C is a portable device which scrambles the audio signal from your cellular or regular phone line to be descrambled by the same device on the called end. The device offers 25 different scrambling codes, which I see as pretty inadequate. To operate, the user dials his phone normally. Then the call is made and verification with a called party is confirmed. A code is chosen and both parties place the receivers onto the coupler of the device and pick up its handset. Conversation then continues normally, all audio being scrambled before being sent over the line or through the air in the case of cellular phones. The device itself takes about as much room as a portable cellular phone and runs continuously up to 20 hours on battery power. And then we have the details of the manufacturer. And with that little message from a 92 hacker, we can now understand what those buttons were doing. We have the options to enable or disable scrambling, as well as those two buttons to select a combination between 5 letters and 5 numbers, thus a total of 25 different combinations. So the two parties could agree on, let's say, we'll be using Bravo 3. And then call each other on the massive early cell phones of the 90s, place their cell phones here, and enable the scrambling with a pre-agreed secret key. Most likely, it was using this secret key to perform frequency inversion, which was one of the most common scrambling methods at the time. In layman's terms, frequency inversion means that it flips the high and low audio frequencies to make the resulting audio unintelligible. However, as long as you know or can figure out how this inversion happens, you can trivially reverse the process. So 25 is definitely not something particularly hard for someone to break, as the 90s hacker that mailed 2600 magazine also noted. And certainly many of our viewers would be interested to know how this looks on the inside. So let's have a look. Do you know more about it? Please let us know. And that was our today's artifact. To give you a perspective of how early this device attempted to solve this weakness, 2G had been introduced just in 1991 in the GSM standard. This likely makes the Privacom P25C one of the earliest commercial attempts to protect cell phone communications. A great example why nothing is as it seems.